Hi guys, long time no see. I'm really sorry that while I was away I didn't make any videos, but I couldn't really find a very ideal place to set my camera up. And I did try and record a couple on the camera that I did my last video on, which my mum has now given to me and which I'm now recording on. It's really great, like quality, but it picks up every little detail and I feel a bit like it's making me look a bit, well, not making me look like anything, but it's kind of enhancing any flaws that I've got. And I've recorded a few videos and deleted them because I kind of think the camera just shows too much detail. But I think I'm going to have to get over that because the quality is really good, the sound's good, and the focus and the macro etc. is really good. So yeah, I'm doing a tutorial for the first time in God knows how long, and this is my look. It's just kind of really bright blue, purpley, black, smoky, dramatic look with a pale lip. So yeah, I hope that you all enjoy it, and I will see you all soon. So I've already primed my eyelid with Urban Decay's Primer Potion, and my first step after that is to take a white eyeshadow. This is just white from Stargazer. And then I'm going to take the Body Shop Smudger Brush, which is just basically like an all-over kind of eyeshadow sponge tip brush. So I'm just going to take the matte white, and I'm just going to put that all over my lid. This doesn't have to be kind of perfect or anything. Just gives a really nice base. I've got a little bit of mascara on, just because I've already worn makeup today, and I kind of just removed it for tutorial purposes. And I didn't want to kind of remove all of my mascara because that kind of really irritates my eyes. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm using this palette today, which is a number 17 Vava Voom palette. And it has four eyeshadows in, which look like this. I really like this palette. It was a free gift a while ago. It's a limited edition. But they're really good. So I'm going to take the dark purple onto number 17 eyeshadow blend and contour brush. So I'm just going to get that right onto the tip of the brush, and then I'm gonna, let me just tap that off a bit more, and I'm gonna just run it right along my crease, and then right on the outer corner I'm just gonna swirl it in just a circular motion, just to really kind of put the colour down there on the outside. You can see it just kind of adds a shadow. So I'm just going to keep doing that and just kind of buff it. Doesn't have to be perfect, just literally put your brush there and just swirl it around and pull it across. Right, then I'm just going to pick up a little bit more colour and I'm going to pull into the crease like so. Then I'm just going to relax my eye so I'm not kind of raising my eyebrows. And I'm just going to run the brush back and forth through my crease like that. I'll just really kind of soften it and blend it and stuff. So that's the purple. It's not a very vivid purple, it's a very kind of dark purple. So to darken it up, I'm going to take my 226 brush from MAC. It looks like this. And I'm going to take the black eyeshadow and just get that onto the tip of the 226, tap it off. This is a really good black eyeshadow. I'm going to place it just there and just look ahead and run that back and forth, and that just really kind of darkens it up, pulling it in and just swirling it at the outer edge, so just like that. So that's basically my crease for now. I will go over it again in a while. Next I'm going to take the Max Factor eyeshadow brush, and I'm just going to dampen it on a makeup wipe, just so it's a little bit wet but not kind of like soaking wet. And I'm going to take the turquoisey blue colour, Aqua they call it. So I'm going to put this on wet, and it kind of just looks awesomely pigmented there. And that's going to go on the free space, obviously, where my eyelid is just completely free of any colour other than the matte white. And I'm just going to paint that on. I'm going to pull it into the purple at the edge of my eye, because you can't really see it there anyway. And pull it up into the purple a little bit as well. I'm going to take the Boots number 7 brush again, and we're going to pick up the purple again. And I'm just going to go back over where I applied the purple before, just to kind of bring that back into it and just to blend it all together so there's a really nice gradient effect. Then under my lash line, I'm going to take a small pencil brush. This one's from Celia Burtwell. And I'm going to take the purple and the black kind of mixed, and I'm just going to run that along my lower lash line, trying to stay in the shot. So just like that. Then I'm going to take the white in the palette, and that's just going to go right on the inner corner and just blend it out into the dark colour underneath, so that it all kind of just blends together like so. Then if you feel like you kind of need to blend around your edges, just take the 224, sweep it around just to really kind of soften and whatever. For my waterline, I'm using Eye Bright from Benefit, which is kind of meant for under your brow bone and on your lash line, but it's really nice in the waterline because it's not quite a bright white, but it's like a, it's kind of a pale pink off-white. It just looks kind of natural, more natural than like a harsh white colour. So I really, really like that. Next step is for liner. I'm taking Rimmel's Flash Liner Liquid Eyeliner. This is amazing and it has a really great long tip on it. And it's really easy and quick to use. So I'm just going to wing it out at the edge and then just start thin on the inner corner and just bring it out and meet it all in the middle. And with my makeup wipe, I'm just going to clean up the edge of the liner like so on both sides so they look the same. Now I'm going to add my mascara, and I'm using the Max Volume Flash from Rimmel, which has got like a lovely, lovely brush, and it just applies really, really nicely. So I'm just going to put a layer of that on. Just clean up a little bit under my eyes. And let me show my nails. Do they look good? Can you see that? Yeah, you can. I did them myself yesterday, trying to get like a leopard print effect, and then I put little silver blobs on, and the little silver blobs kind of ruined it. But they look quite effective from a distance, I think. For my face, which I did kind of clean all of my makeup off, I'm first going to prime with the Prime of Your Life, which is from Primark, believe it or not. £3 and very Benefit-esque packaging. I'm really enjoying this so far. Used it a couple of times. It kind of, let me show you, you squeeze it up and it kind of comes out of the top. There you go. You can see that. So I'm just going to take a little bit of that onto my foundation brush, which is also from Primark, and I'm just going to get it onto my brush, dab it in all the places where I feel like I need to prime. It would be really nice all over because it really kind of gives the skin a brightening effect, but I tend to just put my primer where I have like very open pores to try and fill them in, and where I get really oily, which is basically the centre of my face and my cheeks. And then for foundation, I'm going to use my Clean Makeup from CoverGirl. This is one of my kind of favourite just go-to foundations that is quick and easy to apply. And I'm nearly out of it, so I'm just going to take what's in the lid and just smear it on my face. I'm really out of practice with the tutorials because while I've been away at my mum's, I haven't really done anything. I have recorded 2 other videos before this one that I haven't uploaded, just because the camera has such a good kind of focus on it, and it really kind of makes things look really true to life, that it makes my skin look like really, really terrible, which you're probably seeing right now. And I mean, I don't have the best skin, But I think it probably makes my skin look a lot worse than it is. It kind of highlights every little flaw and I'm like, I can't upload that. So I've deleted a few videos, you know, before now from this camera that I'm just like, I can't upload that. But I think this one, I'm just going to have to stop being really vain about it and just kind of go for it, I think. Next up, I'm going to use my Tatar For Now from Primark under eye concealer with the concealer brush on the other end of the foundation brush. And then I like to just go over it with my finger just to really smooth it out, because your finger kind of warms the product up a bit better. Next up, It Stick from Benefit, just to cover that zit and that zit right there. Same concealer brush. Now I'm just kind of patting that. I'm just going to pat it until it kind of blends. And same here. The Benefit It Stick is a really nice creamy concealer. And it kind of covers really, really surprisingly well. And then my Kabuki brush. I'm going to use my Primark one, just because this seems to be like a Primark fest of a video. And I'm going to use my Cream Puff from Max Factor powder, which I always set with. This is kind of a medium coverage powder, so it just kind of gives me a little bit of extra coverage on top of the foundation. So I'm just buffing that all over like that. So for blush, I'm just going to use a beautiful blusher and highlighter that my sister gave to me recently, bless her. And the blusher is just a blusher. It doesn't have a name or a number. It's from the Makeup Academy, which is quite a cheap brand. And it's a lovely rosy pink colour. And I'm going to use my Max Factor blusher brush for that. It's quite a nice subtle colour. Just blend that onto my cheeks. Then to highlight, the Collection 2000 Shimmering Shade in Just Peachy. And I just kind of swirl my brush into that and just run it along my brow bone and around onto the top of my cheeks. Like so. Then whatever's left, I just go down my nose. And just like that. Next up is the brows. I'm just going to go over them with a toothbrush, like I always do. And then my brow powder is the Vital Radiance, and I just use an angled kind of eyebrow brush. I'm going to use a darker shade because I don't know if you've noticed, but I have dyed my hair. Well, my mum dyed it, and it's very dark. Probably can't tell because it's all kind of pulled back, but it's a lot darker than I've ever gone before, I think. But hey, we'll see. It's a bit dramatic, but I think I'm going to get used to it. Just to give them a bit of shape, and I'll fill them in a little bit. There we go. And lastly for my lips, let me just see if this will focus. It does. It's Pretty Please lipstick from MAC. Sorry, I'm just like loving testing out the camera and being able to focus. Pretty Please looks like this. It's a lovely luster, fairly nude, but not overly nude. Quite an opalescent nude with a kind of a sheen to it, rather than like a completely kind of changing the colour of your lips. So yeah, that's it. Let me just zoom in so you can have a closer look at the look. Right, so that's basically my look finished. Very kind of bright blue blended kind of purple and black, and then my nude-ish lips, and I don't know if you can see what my cheeks look like. So I'm all done. I really, really hope that you enjoyed this tutorial, the first one for a long time. Let me know how the camera quality is and the focus, and I'm sorry about the little bits of messing around with the focus, but I'm just kind of getting used to it myself. And let me know if I look kind of really hideously, you know, because you can see every little kind of flaw. I want to know how bad it is. To me, it looks bad, but I'm sure you'll be honest with me. So I'm going to go, and I hope you all have a great week, weekend, whatever you're up to, and I'll see you soon.